Russell Day.
Welcome, welcome. It's Wednesday. Oh my gosh, it's Wednesday, March 8th, 2017. Back today's Christian Slater.
Thank you so much.
I know.
Good to be here.
I know the feeling. I know how you feel.
Oh,
I get
goodness.
Excited.
Yes, so it's Wednesday. It's hump day.
It is.
And?
It's International Women's Day. Yes, it is.
A wonderful thing.
It's that you men are terrific, and we love you.
Thank
and
you.
We honor you.
Yes.
But it's the women that get you through, right?
Oh, boy.
Women.
Yes. Without question.
Women,
oh, my gosh.
Get you through it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Speaking of women.
Yes.
One of my favorite women I got to interview last night at the 92nd Street Y.
Oh.
Which is something I was so nervous about because I work here,
yes.
People think that I am I interview people all the time. I have a terrible fear of public speaking.
Okay.
And
me too, yeah.
It's weird, right?
Yeah, it's very
it's
strange.
It's almost like we do this to torture ourselves.
I know, put ourselves at, well, face the fear.
Face the fear.
That's right.
Face the fear.
Right.
Anyway, so her name is Stacey Griffith. She's been my SoulCycle instructor for 10 years. Like, when she started training, I started taking SoulCycle.
Oh.
And I took all of these notes on the book because I like to know what I'm talking about for these things. I don't want to just go up there and wing it and whatever.
Yeah.
I don't think we mentioned anything about the book once. We just got into, you know, first of all, we got into the fact that we've never seen each other outside of SoulCycle, so we didn't know what we looked like, not sweaty and without makeup on.
Oh, my goodness, yes.
So this was us. I have pictures of us. It's kind of amazing. Like, we looked, we looked glamorous. We look glam.
That's okay? Amazing. Yes.
Yeah. Look at us.
So that's out of SoulCycle class, obviously.
Out of SoulCycle class.
They didn't wheel in any bikes for you guys to pedal around on. No.
But she wrote something in her intro that I thought was so funny, and it made me laugh. And I read it out loud to her last night because I want her to change when the paperback comes out. I want her to change this part.
Okay.
So listen to. Oh, these are my questions. This is. So listen to this. I'm flattered when people say I'm the Tony Robbins of exercise, a combination of the mindful focus of Deepak Chopra, the exuberant high energy of Kelly Ripa, and the cool sexiness of Pink.
Wow.
Why does Pink get to be cool?
Interesting.
And sexy?
Yeah.
Why is it always Pink?
I would have rewritten that.
Right.
Yeah, I would have. I would have changed that around.
I highlighted it in green.
Good for you. Yes. Yeah. That's great. That's great.
Is that funny?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
So but it was really great. It was it's such an institution, and to be there and to not screw it up made me very happy.
That's huge. Yeah. Well done. So great.
The book is out, and if you want a really good book and you can't get to a SoulCycle class, it gives you practical advice.
And if you read it, you lose calories.
You definitely lose calories.
Yeah, it's incredible. It's amazing.
But she takes you on a journey, and it's about mindfulness and what you put in your body and how you talk to yourself. It's a very good, I highly recommend it. So that's for you.
Nice.
Just for you guys.
Cool.
Women's Day.
How often do you do that? How often do you take the classes and go there?
I would say three times a week.
Three times a week?
Yeah.
Wow. Mm-hmm. And do you do it before or after?
It depends. It depends on
scheduling.
My schedule. Yeah.
Oh, cool.
But I have to say there were people, because that was a big talking point, like how often do you do it?
Mm-hmm.
And there are people in the audience that do it four times a day.
Ooh.
Four times a day. They probably can eat whatever they want.
Yeah.
I'm assuming they just eat everything. All
sure, yeah. I mean, they're eating while they're pedaling.
Yeah.
I mean, that's incredible.
I'm hungry after I do SoulCycle.
Yeah, I would imagine that would...
Have you ever done it?
I have done it once, and it is a very exciting class because you do get very competitive, and they put the thing up on the board. You can see how
other... that's flywheel. That's different.
Are they?
That's flywheel.
That's flywheel. I've done flywheel. I have not done this.
I'm going to take you to SoulCycle.
Okay, cool.
I'm going to take you to Stacey's class. You're going to have a ball.
Okay, good.
Because it's like a disco for older people.
Oh, very nice.
Not that you're an older person.
No, hey, I'm in. I'll take it. I'm with it. Totally.
I'm fine. Yeah.
So did you hear about, now we're all enjoying like a nice warm weather situation here.
All right.
I know.
All right.
Not to be the...
You guys, You guys, it was 17 on Saturday.
I know, yeah. Well, so let's enjoy this day, because today is going to be about 60.
Really?
Right? Yes, yeah. So enjoy that as much as you can, because a cold front is coming. Yep. And snow late this week could be the first of several disruptive snowstorms. I know, yeah.
I can't take
yeah,
it
so
anymore.
Let's stay indoors or do a lot of soul cycle,
yes.
And that's what we're going to be doing.
Yeah. I have to say that this is the Harry Potter weather of New York City,
yes.
in March.
Hmm.
March, it is 60, then it snows, then it's 60, then it snows.
Right.
And all I know is I always have the wrong coat.
Yeah, you never know what to wear, right?
My coat is always wrong.
Oh,
on the day
confusing.
It was 17, I had a windbreaker. Yeah. And today, I wore Canada Goose.
Yeah, yeah.
So,
thank goodness for those Canada Goose jackets, right? Those are fantastic, but in the right circumstance.
I said to Mark, what did I do before I got a really warm coat? Because I didn't used to, before I got married and became an adult and had children.
Yes.
And it wasn't really until I had children
right.
that I bought myself a warm coat.
Wow.
Because I was so focused on buying them warm coats, and
that's
I said,
interesting. Yeah.
This coat is warm.
Yeah, yeah.
And yeah. I bought myself a warm coat, and guess what? It was amazing.
Yeah.
Because I used to just buy coats for how they looked on me.
Okay, so not actually for the practicality.
No, it never occurred to me to buy a coat that would be weather resistant.
No, of course, of course. It's all about the style and how it looks.
Oh,
and
right.
No, I know. No, it's incredible to me how little clothing women can wear out in the freezing cold weather.
If
you
we,
know, for the, it's amazing. I mean,
if
with
we, if
their
we
legs
look
exposed,
good, right.
and I go, it's insane.
If we look
the
good,
level of strength that it takes to be a woman is phenomenal. I take my hat off to you. Yeah.
It truly does take a lot to kill.
You know what? I saw Logan last night.
Oh,
I went
yes.
and saw it.
Did you cry? Did you cry?
I did, yeah. I wanted to come in here today and say I didn't cry because I've shared so many things this week about my love of The Bachelor,
right,
my man crush of Daniel Craig, and I cried at Logan. So I'm like a triple threat of...
Yeah, we like it. We like that about you.
Okay.
We like that a lot about
But fantastic
it.
Movie.
Yeah.
I really loved it.
It
yeah,
opened,
very powerful.
It opened huge at the box office.
$85
million. $85 million.
Yeah, so good for, again. But yeah, Hugh Jackman is great in it, and
I
loved it.
Hugh Jackman and Samuel L. Jackson and all of those guys that open those movies consistently,
yes.
like, I think
yes.
Samuel L. Jackson has, like,
$2
the highest.
$2 billion, right. Two more than that. Yeah.
And yourself, for that matter. Let's talk about you.
$1.6 billion.
When you open movies big like that, do you get to keep some of that money? It's like that, that's what I'm curious
well,
about.
Well, I mean, it depends on how you define the word some. You know, some of the money, I suppose, yeah, I got a couple of quarters, you know. I got a small portion of that.
Small portion.
Yeah, a small portion of that, so
right.
it's very nice.
Okay.
Enough for
later
coffee
on
and
during
tea.
Commercial break, you'll tell us how small, because we're curious.
Okay, yeah.
I'm curious.
Yeah, under the radar, under wraps, of course, we can have that.
Like, I want to know where to put you in my prayer circle. Like, should you be way over here, or should you be, like, dead in the middle of it?
Center.
Center.
Get me
okay.
in there.
All right, you're in.
Yeah, say
you're
some prayers.
Yeah, yeah.
Please,
you're
that'd
in,
be
you're
fantastic.
In. You're in. Hey, did you guys want to know where the happiest place on earth is? Listen
oh, we knew, but okay.
I thought it was New York City.
I thought it was right here.
That's not
this
here.
Spot right here. Yeah.
Wrong again.
Okay.
Naples, Florida is the happiest and healthiest city in America.
Wow. Who knew?
I was discussing this with Gelman backstage, and he goes, that's where I get all my wine.
Naples, yes.
That's what he said. You said, I participate in a wine auction there. And you know, Kelly, that if I sold my wine, it would be worth more than all my stocks combined.
Wow.
Things like that, but it was...
You said something like that. Something like that. If, as a matter of fact, if I would just stop drinking my wine, I'd be a billionaire. Something like that.
Yeah.
I'd stop drinking.
In those lines.
Yeah, something like that. I mean, he may
Very
not
posh.
Have said those exact words.
Very posh. I
yeah.
was listening
yeah.
to the glass to the thing. That's exactly what he said.
But there is a big wine auction there. Am I mistaken?
Yeah, no,
nice.
It's a huge one. It's
huge
terrific.
One.
Yeah.
It's where you get a lot of the Gelman family wine.
No, I visited it, but I visited the auction.
You visited yes. the auction.
You don't have your own vineyard or anything?
No, nothing
no?
like that.
Shocking.
Do you ever think about planting your own grapes and...
Oh, I have planted some out in Long Island, but just enough for...
You mean in Long Island at the secondary home?
The summer home.
Very few grapes.
Very few grapes. Yeah.
Do you get in there and crush the grapes ever? Do you ever put them in a...
I have a little barrel. Yeah. And, well, it's not that many grapes.
The family... That's a family barrel.
It's been passed down from generation to generation.
My wife, Lori, whittled the barrel herself, and then we let the children...
I chopped the tree down.
We let the marital children crush the grapes.
Oh, man. That's good.
How did I become an English lord?
I don't know. I now picture you as an English lord.
Yeah, that's great. I wish.
I don't know. And you've taken up smoking.
Smoking.
But what fascinates me about this is how I insist on holding my hand up to my face, even though I don't put makeup on my
face.
I gotta never do it.
Oh, no.
What color differential? There's no difference.
No, no, no. It all matched up. Yeah, we'll do the balance later. It'll be perfect.
Mm-hmm.
And now, speaking of looks, have you ever tried this? Because Kristen Stewart has debuted her new look on the red carpet.
Let me say it.
And we're going to try this out. Let's say it. This way? This way.
Zip-zoo.
Yeah. Yeah. Look at that.
But she can do that. She has a beautiful, delicate face.
Let's. Can we split screen it and see what I mean?
No way.
I mean, you have a beautiful, delicate.
No, I have a giant head.
Bring out the clippers.
Oh, you know what? I should go to Jeffrey Dean Morgan's on shave day. He has alpaca and stuff, and they shave.
That's correct. What? Oh, they did it.
No, but.
It looks good.
No. Okay, look at what they did, though.
What?
They put half of my face on her neck because...
Yeah.
You see what I'm talking about, right?
What is going on? Yeah.
Because my face is twice the size of any regular person's face.
No.
It's like a hot air balloon.
It's a sign of genius.
It's a sign of something. Oh, man.
Hey! That's it. I love it. Now, why do I really have a double chin?
No.
I got a double chin
No, you don't.
That's what I looked like in The Legend of Billie Jean. That was actually my look. Yeah, incredible.
Gosh, every time you reference one of your films, I go, oh, that's another one.
That's
a great film.
That's right.
Yeah. So, guys, do you want to feel super old? Who here wants to feel super old? Raise your hands.
That's always my first
choice
in the morning.
Nobody wants to feel old.
Yeah.
30 years ago today.
Yes.
No, 30 years ago yesterday.
Okay.
Sorry, I'm a day late and a dollar short. The Beastie Boys' License to Ill album became the number one rap album.
Wow.
The first...
Yeah. Oh. Man.
Right?
Wow. That was tough. That was good.
I feel like there's not enough people old enough to appreciate that the Beastie Boys had a number one rap album. It was the first rap album to become number one.
Isn't that amazing? That is a wonderful piece
of
history.
And yet nobody cares. And I'm going to tell you why. It's spring break and our audience is younger than normal.
Was that on that album?
Yeah.
I hope so.
Yes, that's right.
You gotta fight. Remember that?
Oh, you're right. To party!
Yeah. That's right. Long live the Beastie Boys.
And do you know something, young lady?
Ooh.
I used to listen to that on my cassette tape.
Wow.
You really did.
Cassette tape.
You remember those things? Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
8 tracks. We talked
about it last night. How Stacey Griffith, when she used to teach aerobics class, would have to like line up her CDs.
Yes.
She had like a CD changer, and she would have to program it to change.
Yeah, we all had those big cases of CD things, holders.
And there were young people staring at us like, "What are they talking about?" And I was like, "Okay, there used to be albums."
Yeah.
that you would play with a needle, and then the 8-track that looked like a big ham sandwich that you would put, and then like right halfway through like the middle song, it would flip over in the middle of the, and then CDs came. I mean, no, and then cassettes came.
Right.
And then CDs came.
Did you ever make any mixtapes? Did you ever do any?
Of course.
God. Yes, I still have. Yes.
You had
yes.
your favorites.
Yes. Yes.
Love songs.
Love songs.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yep. And then, CDs came, and then albums again. So we're back to square one. Because albums.
Full circle. Thank goodness.
And of course, how old are you? The girl behind you. How old are you? You.
I'm 14.
And you're how old? 15. Okay, 14, 15.
My daughter's age.
And I'm gonna
great tell, age.
Yeah, that's our daughter's age. Not ours. We each have daughters.
Big reveal on today's show. We have a 15-year-old daughter.
But they're like, we download music. We don't even know what you're talking about.
That's right.
Right on my computer from the interweb.
Oh my
right?
Goodness.
That's what you're thinking. Right. Exactly. She's like, as a matter of fact, I've never seen this show. I don't even know what's happening.
What's going on? What are these guys doing?
Are you available on the interweb? Because I don't. Are you on the gram? And so my daughter's like, why can't you get on Ellen DeGeneres? That's a really good show.
Oh, no.
Right. I'm like, it's okay. It's all right. It's good.
We'll be dancing in the aisles
yeah.
later.
Yeah, yeah.
It's coming. It's coming. Oh, yeah. Look at this. Thumbs
yeah.
up for that.
Yeah.
Yay!
Yeah. Is that where your parents told you you were coming today? Sorry.
Psych. Oh, well.
Hey, we got a big show today.
Huge Keri, show.
Keri Russell's here.
Beautiful, delicate face. Yeah, we should try that look
yes,
on her.
Yeah, we should.
Jenna Elfman also is here.
Another.
Yeah.
We wanna put the shaved head on Jenna and Keri because they both have
that. And Gelman.
Right. And
by
Gelman.
The way.
Yeah.
How come he hasn't had one of these?
Oh, he's done it.
These
he's
doctors
done it.
Doctored photos.
No, no. Gelman was blonde and had a short haircut.
Oh.
Yeah, there was a moment.
All right, we'll have it. We'll have it soon. I'm sure it's coming.
Oh yeah. Well, that's not. Yeah.
Whoa!
Wow.
Wow.
That was shame.
Not bad. Yeah. That's not as bad as I thought it was going to be. That's pretty good.
Yeah, I don't remember that because I was in eighth grade then.
Yeah. That's right.
Oh, no, I was working down the street. Okay. Hey, Peter Gross is here with some baby animals.
Oh, wait until you see these animals.
Black bear.
I know. I heard
and
this.
An anteater.
Unbelievable.
And my personal favorite, a bush baby.
Yeah. Wait until you see. Yeah, yeah.
Love a bush baby. Very exciting.
Very cuddly.
Okay. And it's also time for, we don't have the bush baby?
What?
No.
Oh.
No?
The
bush baby stayed home, slept in.
Oh.
But we
were all
talent.
Misled.
Yep.
The bush
we'll
baby.
We'll have to get by with the bear.
All right.
Yeah. It's
well,
a big bear, right?
Then I'm leaving.
Yeah. She stomps out.
Okay. You ready?
Yeah.
It's time for winter lip sync travel trivia.
Wow.
Yeah.
Good work. Kathy Sanders from Rockville, Maryland.
Yeah, yeah.
What a
job, Kath. Good job.
First class. Amazing.
I had the cassette tape of that. It was dope and fly. Okay, let's say hi to Susan Payne from Laurel, Maryland. Hey, Susan.
Susan, you there?
Actually, it's Kathy Sanders from Rockville, Maryland.
Oh.
Hi, trivia caller from Rockville.
Hi. My gosh, do you guys know each other?
No.
No, okay. So, we have our trivia, we have our cards mixed up.
Oh, do we?
Susan Payne.
Okay.
Susan Payne. We're,
yeah.
Okay, and you're, yeah, great.
Okay.
And you're in Laurel, Maryland. Okay,
yes.
She was the dancer, and this is fantastic.
But you two don't know each other.
No.
No relation whatsoever.
You guys should meet, because I think you'd be friends.
Dancing together would be very nice. I could see it.
Where are you in this photo?
I'm at my son's college graduation last May.
Oh.
Where is that? University of Texas?
No, it's High Point University in North Carolina.
Oh, okay. Oh, congratulations.
Yeah.
Right. Susan. I have a son in college. Is your son working?
Yes, he actually got a nice job right out of college.
Wow. Whoa! It's gotta be the happiest day in a parent's life right there.
Yes.
Oh, my God. To come out of college into a job.
Into a job.
Well done. You've won at life.
Yeah.
Whatever happens next, you've won.
Susan, we're going to spin the wheel and see what you're playing for, okay?
Yes.
Oh, there's a great prize.
The
Fairmont Mayacoba Resort in Riviera Maya, Mexico.
Hey.
7 days and six nights. Oh, you want those 6 nights. It includes all meals. All meals?
All meals.
Even
all meals.
Snacks?
Even.
Wow.
A private boat tour? A private boat tour. Probably captained by a captain. And the trip is provided in part by Hotels.com. It's a prize ride at $7,500. You have 20 seconds and only one guest. Susan, good luck.
That's a good value. $7,500.
Okay,
here's the question. On yesterday's show, we talked with Tom Hiddleston. He mentioned he played the right front leg of an animal in a high school play. What animal's leg did Tom say he once played?
The elephant?
Congratulations, you and a guest will enjoy 7 days and six nights at the Fairmont Mayacoba Resort on the Riviera Maya in Mexico. The magic of the Mayan culture intertwines with world-class facilities at the AAA Five Diamond and Rainforest Alliance Verified Resort. Enjoy Richard Sandoval's creative cuisine at four renewed restaurants, on-property boat tours, the Willow Stream Spa, and El Camaleon, the only course in Mexico to host an official PGA Tour event. Your prize is valued at approximately $7,500.
Yes, yes, yes. Okay, congratulations, Susan. Now you can help a lucky member of our studio audience receive 8 place settings of American-made fine china from Lennox, valued at more than $500. Now please pick a number between 1 and 235.
14.
Larson is here.
From the series The Catch, Peter Krause.
All right.
Yes.
Now, let's bring out. She was at Mouseketeer. She was Felicity. And now she's the Emmy-nominated star of The Americans. Please welcome back to the show, Keri Russell.
Great shoes.
Thank you.
Oh, come on. Look at the shoes.
Oh, my gosh. Wait, are you wearing a little anklet? Oh, wow.
Look at that.
How fun. Come on.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, fabulosa.
You are the chicest.
Thanks, hey, guys.
Congratulations on your baby.
Oh, yes.
Oh, my God.
Thank you.
9 months. 9 months old?
9 months.
Oh, congratulations. Yes.
A giant 9-month-old baby.
Is he giant?
He's a giant.
Wow.
Did your babies get progressively bigger?
Yeah, they were giant.
I mean, like, they started normal, and then now I'm giant.
I think it's something about petite people have giant children so that people can marvel over how we didn't die.
Yeah, it kind of is.
Right?
It's very
yeah, interesting.
Makes sense, yes. Yeah. How did you do that? Yeah,
it's Matthew incredible. Was here. He told us the baby only speaks Welsh. Yeah, are you having a hard time understanding the baby?
Matthew only speaks Welsh to the baby, and he could be speaking, you know, saying anything. Like, let's leave them. Like, who knows? Like, who knows so what he's like?
You have no translator.
No translator.
Oh, wow.
They're speaking
that's
in
tricky.
Their own language. No, but it's really...
He said that you're starting to speak it, though, a little bit.
A little bit.
Yeah.
You know, I can count. I know numbers. Willa, the 5-year-old, kind of speaks it the best. And it just shows you that's... When you're little, that's when you should
learn
something.
That's when you're...
Like, I know nothing. I blame my parents. I speak one language.
Right.
Like, when you're little, you have to... Like, learn all of those things.
Now, is it a chaos at home? I mean, you have 3 kids,
right? We have
right?
a full tribe.
Do you have animals? Do you have pets? I mean, are they...
We do not have pets.
No
although,
pets.
Although my son, River, has a whole plot. You have pets.
I have a job. Yeah. I'm just telling you.
Yeah.
Don't do it. You have enough.
It's another
pets
level.
Pets are like cocktails. 3 is like 30.
So River is desperate for another cat. We used to have a cat. And the only way, he's plotting this whole thing about to get another cat, which is Matthew has this fear of rats.
Huh.
Like,
oh,
well. Like a, well, I mean, who loves rats?
Yeah,
I mean, many people love rats. Like, he is obsessed with being afraid with
of rats.
Like, he watches documentaries on them. I mean,
Why? It's insane.
What, I mean, I don't know. He's just so afraid of them.
Yeah.
And so River's like, on the way to school, I was walking him, and he's like, do you think if I start telling Math that I saw a rat in Sam's crib, do you think he'd let us get it? He'd let us get a cat?
That's so dark.
I know. Yeah. And I was like, you know what? You're onto something.
Yeah.
Clever plan. Get in his head. Yeah, exactly.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah. I don't think that's a good idea. Because it's like tempting fate, right?
It is. I mean,
there will be a rat.
Although I will say this. I will say that I saw a rat in a snowstorm, and it's the only time I wasn't afraid of the rat. The rat was diving through the snow and so happy, and I was like, snow rat.
Yeah.
So adorable.
Yeah.
I mean, come on.
I mean, it's really
cute. They're just trying to exist. They're just trying to live. They're just trying to live.
And find pizza.
Yeah. And
survivors.
When we come back, we're going to talk about In its fifth season,
you
play a Russian spy.
It's true.
Living underground as an American citizen.
Yep.
You get to wear lots of cockamamie disguises. Do you have a favorite?
That's my personal favorite. That's a very attractive one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
These days we like the kind of the more unattractive. That's one of Matthew's favorites. I love that I was supposed to be this like menacing killer.
Yeah.
And that's Kelly Ripa.
Look at that.
Yeah, that's definitely me. That is me, no doubt.
What's going on? Yeah, yeah, it's incredible.
Yeah, yeah, that's me.
But yeah, we tend to like the kind of more unattractive they are, the better we like them.
Well, I said
I'm a flight attendant there.
Oftentimes when I watch The Americans, I liken your looks to, you know, those magazines where they're like the haircut magazines.
Yes.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yes.
It's like
this is
a
what
series.
Look like here.
This is the series of the haircut magazine photos.
It is.
Correct.
You go, oh, this is what I would look like if I did this, like, short blonde. Yeah.
Did you ever refuse to wear any of them?
You know what? In the early days, there was like a Felicity type curly wig that they kept trying to throw on me. I was like, guys, come on.
Been there. I lived it
for many years. Let's not go back.
Oh, there it is. I'm just
Have you ever known someone to have bigger hair than that?
Incredible hair.
Never.
No. Like, no.
God loves you more.
He gave you
everything. The hair. Yeah.
I mean,
sure.
It was just like so much hair.
Well, listen. Do you know, because it's the second to last season, right?
Correct. So we have season 5, and then we have a short, just 10-episode season next year.
Mm-hmm.
We asked Matthew, do you know how it ends?
They let you in on the secrets?
We have no idea how it ends.
Okay.
And you know what? I'm surprised every time. Even this season, I was reading episode 10. There's like this huge spread, you know, 11, 12. They have their own thing going. I have no idea.
No idea. So they keep you in the dark.
Well, then we're going to have to
tune in. And beloved for her role in Dharma and Greg, now she stars in new sitcom Imaginary Mary. Please welcome Jenna Elfman. So good. Yeah, great to see you.
I didn't get to high five down here.
Commercial break.
Get out.
You always have a super chic haircut, but this is this is the chicest of all of your hair.
Really?
Yeah, I like it a lot.
It's great.
Super good.
Great dress and outfit, skirt, and happy Woman's Day.
Happy Woman's Day, Christian.
Come on.
Yeah. Well, you know what?
How does it feel?
I love it.
I know, we're good, right?
My favorite day of the year.
We're good to have around.
Oh, boy. The most important thing ever.
Did you know
that
Jenna was a classically trained ballerina.
You know what? I did not know that. I cannot
believe that. That was like a whole lifetime before becoming an actress.
I mean, look at your legs.
Come on.
It's super unfair.
Beautiful. Stunning.
Yeah, that was great.
What made you sort of leave ballet? Because ballet is, I think, brutal for your body.
It is brutal,
and then you went to,
I just had this ankle injury that kept flaring up, and I was about to go into a ballet company, and then I was like icing my ankle more than I was performing, and I went, that's not a career, that's just depressing. So I transferred and started dancing TV film and danced on the Academy Awards. And
no kidding.
Yeah, I was one of those little dancers on the Academy Awards.
Are you kidding?
Yeah, in 1991.
Cool. Yeah.
Holy cow.
Yeah, and then that was like the best gig I could get in LA, and it wasn't enough to fortify my artistic goals.
Yes.
Is fortify the right word?
Yeah, I'm gonna say yes.
All right, let's just go with yeah. And so then I started doing commercials and started acting.
Wow.
Yeah.
That is great.
I wanted to be able to reach more people and impinge joy and everything on more people, and I didn't feel I could do that the way I wanted to as a dancer. I was like that big on screen and one of 25, and had bigger goals of wanting to impinge on the world, so I started acting.
And then you met Bodhi. Now he's your husband. You're celebrating how many years?
22 married years, 26 22 years.
22 married years.
I love that picture.
You guys look very happy on that day. That's incredible.
You said 22 married years.
Yes.
Because that counts all of the other years.
Yeah, that's
they
time invested.
Yes.
That's big. So, yeah, before the 22, how long were you guys?
Four. So we're 26 years
26
together.
26 years total. Okay, good. Wow.
I think that's a record.
I think it is a record. It's not like easy.
No, definitely something to be very proud of.
That's,
for sure.
That's hard work.
Listen,
especially him.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. He's so difficult. No, we're going to find out what it's like having an imaginary friend when we come back from commercial break, so stick around. That's Jenna Elfman in a scene from Imaginary Mary, where you are dating a divorced father, right?
Yeah.
He's got three kids.
Yeah.
And your childhood imaginary friend comes back to visit you.
Yeah.
To give you guidance.
Because I'm stressed out.
It's a stressful situation.
Right.
Three kids. Oh,
well, when I was young, my character's parents fought, divorced, and were never there for me.
Yes.
So I have no example of a working relationship, and I'm terrified and don't want one. I don't want kids. My character just wants nothing to do with it.
Right.
But to keep this wonderful guy in my life, I have to engage, even though I want to see if I cannot engage. But apparently, if you want to have a meaningful relationship with someone,
right, you got to talk to them.
You have to engage with their children. And I'm like, oh, and she comes back.
Oh,
right.
Wow.
And then helps sort of walk me through it.
So sort of a life coach.
Yeah, she's Mary like my good voice and bad voice at the same time.
Oh, very nice.
So how does it work? What are you acting opposite against?
Well,
because that's like a CGI critter.
That is totally CGI. Yeah, that's all done after the fact. For rehearsal, we have a life-size puppet and a puppeteer.
And does it look like that? Is the puppet like
that? No, that's an early version of the character.
As
you saw on the thing, she looks a little bit different. So that was an early set thing.
Right.
But yeah, she kind of she looks like Mary, and we have a puppeteer, so I rehearse. Uh-huh. And then we film one take with her there so the animators have a sense of her in the space.
Interesting.
But then she goes away, and I film the whole thing with nothing. There's not a green ball. There's no green.
Nothing.
It literally looks like this.
Oh my God.
But how challenging is that?
It's very challenging because sometimes I'll have like 11 eye lines in one thing. As she's moving around the room, I'm moving around the room. So we have the dimension changes, and then I have to also make it funny, remember the eye lines. It's really, but that's why I was excited about this script and this project is I felt like at this point in my career, I was really up for a new comedic challenge.
Sure.
And it's a new dimension, and there's romance, and there's kids, and there's physical comedy, and there's this character. It's like a very full show.
Oh, well, you're doing it. That,
nailed
that is it. That's a challenge.
Yeah. Amazing.
It's Imaginary Mary premieres Wednesday, March 29th at 8:30 p.m. on ABC. Make sure you check out Jenna Elfman, Imaginary Mary. Who we got next?
Baby animals. Yeah. Everyone loves a baby, especially me.
Aww.
And today we have some of the cutest from the animal kingdom here to show us some of his friends is the co-host from the original Mutual of Omaha's Wild Kingdom, Peter Gross.
You never know what he's coming out with.
What?
A tiny baby.
Oh,
a tiny
my
baby.
Goodness.
Hi, little one.
Yeah. out.
Oh my goodness.
That's old North American black bear.
You yes. Angel.
And the good news is they're coming back. They're yes. doing great.
Oh my gosh, so strong. So,
but what we need to know is that when we're out camping and hiking and yes. we see them, the never. Only problem they'll have with black bears is if you get between them and they're young.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Never let that happen. If that happens, you want to turn and get away as quickly as you can.
Yeah. What happened?
And
what
there's the mom. Oh no.
But okay. basically, they're omnivorous. They're out gathering food. They don't think of people as food at all.
Right.
And we just respect the fact that they've come back and they're doing so well.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. Yeah. You have no idea. It's incredible. This creature is amazing.
And they're born blind and hairless?
Well, that's right. When they're born, when the mother is almost a hibernation stage, they're blind and they're handless. And they migrate up where they start to nurse. And then about this time of year, she'll be bringing them out.
Oh, my gosh.
Okay, so we're going to let her go back right now.
I love you. You're my best friend.
For several months.
No.
This.
Oh.
This is.
Yeah.
Yep.
Wow.
Is that? That's an anteater?
Yeah, feel the hair. How coarse.
Oh, my gosh.
How coarse that hair is.
Yeah. Oh, that's, yeah.
South American anteater known as a temandua.
A temandua. Oh.
And look at these huge, long claws defending itself.
So when they're scared, they make stinky.
They do. They emit an odor. He's not scared now. He's just exploring.
Give him time.
Yeah.
Primarily, he takes these long claws looking for huge termite mounds and insects and tears them apart.
But this is a banana.
Sloth-like claw.
He'll eat a banana.
He'll also eat some fruit. There we go. I didn't mean to surprise you.
Oh, look at that.
There we go. He's going to hold those long claws. I think he's killing the other animals that are out there. There he goes.
Oh, yeah.
But they're arboreal. You'll find them mostly in trees. This 14-inch tongue comes out
into
a mouthful of termites and then sucks them all in. They're a great source of protein.
Christian is really impressed now. There you go.
Yeah, okay. He wins the prize.
Right, so
that's
we're going to go ahead and let him go back
now. Thank you,
Peter. There we go.
14-inch tongue. That's amazing.
There you go. That's where you can have
one. Oh, look at these guys.
What? Yeah.
Who's this?
Oh, hi, you broccoli.
There you go.
Hi, baby. Got to hold it.
Here we go.
Sure, okay.
Oh, my God. Look at them.
Are they twins?
Nutria. They're brother and sister, but they're Nutria. Nice and firmly so he's comfortable. There you go.
Oh, yeah, look.
These were originally from South America. Brought to this country because of the wonderful fur that
they have. They're so soft.
They are incredibly soft because they're aquatic.
People would wear them?
They actually, in the old days, thought that was a thing to do.
Oh. They have like webbed feet.
Because most of their lives in the water, they can stay underwater for up to 5 minutes at a time.
Oh.
And they have incredible teeth like most rodents do, where the front grows faster than the back. I'm loving this guy.
Can you domesticate these guys? Are they
don't make good pets.
They don't make good pets?
No wild animal ever makes a good pet.
No, you're right. Terrible idea.
We always get like a warped sense here because they're so sweet. They're having their broccoli and they like their broccoli,
and these had to be hand-raised, but they become wonderful ambassadors for their species.
Listen, we're going to take a commercial break when we find out what animals used to be considered vermin and now they're a huge tourist attraction. Well, with Peter Gross,
stick
around.
Oh my.
We're back with Peter Gross, who has more baby animals. I don't know what he's about to bring out, but something's coming out.
It's going to be good.
Hello, Joey.
Oh my goodness.
Some?
In his little pouch. This is very similar to the pouch that he would still be in the wild.
Get it up. There you go.
That's right. He's a marsupial.
Oh, there he goes. Yeah.
There we go.
Oh, he's a marsupial. Mm-hmm.
Just a little bit. Not too far. Oh, there you go.
Sorry.
Okay. Just like that.
All right.
So nice.
And
so
I love imagine, him, her,
her. Her. Imagine this. When she was born, she was the size of a jelly bean.
No.
Absolutely.
And then she crawls into the pouch.
Migrates up into the pouch and stays there up to 6 months, which is about what she is now, about 5.5, 6 months.
Oh, just lovely.
But they live in the pouch for a long time, right?
They're coming and going. As they get older, when mother bends over to graze, she'll climb out and spend some time and then run and leap back in.
Right.
Oh.
And then as they get to be a little larger than this, mother gets tired of all the housekeeping, if you know what I mean.
Yes.
So she dumps them out, and out they go, start to graze with the others.
Can we put her down and see if she'll hop?
Sure.
Why don't you hold this for a minute?
Yeah, I'll take the bottle. Yeah.
We'll sit it right down here.
Okay.
Let's see what happens here.
Shoo-ba-doo.
Oh, my
gosh.
There
you go, kid.
Come on out.
She's so cute.
Independence.
There you go.
Oh, buddy. Some milk. Oh, for you.
Oh, my gosh, she's a dog.
There you go.
Oh, good for you.
Christian, you're good at this.
Oh. Yeah. Now, notice this is all muscle.
Yeah, that tail is really like a third leg, right?
And they have this very comfortable gait.
We have to go.
We have to go.
But tomorrow, okay. Peter Krause and Brie Larson will be here. Peter Gross, everybody. Hi.
Wow.
Welcome.
They're Russell Day.
Welcome, welcome. It's Wednesday. Oh, my gosh, it's Wednesday, March 8th, 2017. Back today's Christian Slater.
Thank you so much.
I know.
Good to be here.
I know the feeling. I know how you feel.
Oh,
I get excited.
Yes, so it's Wednesday. It's hump day.
It is.
And?
It's International Women's Day. Yes, it is.
A wonderful thing.
It's like you men are terrific, and we love you.
Thank
and
you.
We honor you.
Yes.
But it's the women that get you through, right?
Oh boy.
Women.
Yes. Without question.
Women
oh my gosh.
Get you through it.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Speaking of women.
Yes.
One of my favorite women, I got to interview last night at the 92nd Street Y, which is something I was so nervous about because. Because I work here,
yes.
People think that I am I interview people all the time. I have a terrible fear of public speaking.
Okay.
And
me too. Yeah. Yeah.
It's weird, right?
Yeah, it's very strange.
It's almost like we do this to torture ourselves.
I know. Put ourselves at, well, face the fear.
Face the fear.
That's right.
Face the fear.
Right.
Anyway, so her name is Stacey Griffith. She's been my SoulCycle instructor for 10 years. Like when she started training, I started taking SoulCycle.
Oh.
And I took all of these notes on the book because I like to know what I'm talking about for these things. I don't want to just go up there and wing it and whatever.
Yeah.
I don't think we mentioned anything about the book once. We just got into, you know, first of all, we got into the fact that we've never seen each other outside of SoulCycle, so we didn't know what we looked like, not sweaty and without makeup on.
Oh, my goodness, yes.
So this was us. I have pictures of us. It's kind of amazing. Like, we looked, we looked glamorous. We looked glam.
That's amazing. Yes.
Yeah. Look at us.
So that's out of SoulCycle class, obviously.
Out of SoulCycle class.
Yeah, they didn't wheel in any bikes for you guys to pedal around on. No.
But she wrote something in her intro that I thought was so funny, and it made me laugh, and I read it out loud to her last night because I want her to change, when the paperback comes out, I want her to change this part.
Okay.
So listen to, these are my questions. This is, so listen to this. I'm flattered when people say I'm the Tony Robbins of exercise, a combination of the mindful focus of Deepak Chopra, the exuberant high energy of Kelly Ripa, and the cool sexiness of Pink.
Wow.
Why does Pink get to be cool?
Interesting.
And sexy?
Yeah.
Why is it always Pink?
I would have rewritten that.
Right.
Yeah, I would have. I would have changed that around.
I highlighted it in green.
Good for you. Yes. Yeah, that's great. That's great.
Is that funny?
Yeah.
But it was really great. It was it's such an institution, and to be there and to not screw it up made me very happy.
That's huge. Yeah, well done. So great.
The book is out, and if you want a really good book and you can't get to a SoulCycle class, it gives you practical advice.
And if you read it, you lose calories.
You definitely lose calories.
Yeah, it's incredible. It's amazing.
But she takes you on a journey, and it's about mindfulness and what you put in your body and how you talk to yourself. It's a very good, I highly recommend it. So that's for you.
Nice.
Just for you guys.
Cool.
Women's Day.
How often do you do that? How often do you take the classes and go there?
I would say three times a week.
Three times a week?
Yeah.
Wow. Mm-hmm. And do you do it before or after?
It depends. It depends on
scheduling.
My schedule. Yeah.
Oh, cool.
But I have to say there were people, and because that was a big talking point, like how often do you do it?
Mm-hmm.
And there are people in the audience that do it four times a day.
Ooh.
Four times a day. They probably can eat whatever they want.
Yeah.
I'm assuming they just eat everything. All
sure, time. Sure, yeah. I mean, they're eating while they're pedaling.
Yeah.
I mean, that's incredible.
I'm hungry after I do SoulCycle.
Yeah, I would imagine that would...
Have you ever done it?
I have done it once, and it is a very exciting class because you do get very competitive, and they put the thing up on the board. You can see how
That's flywheel. That's different.
Are they?
That's flywheel.
I've done flywheel. I have not done this.
I'm going to take you to SoulCycle.
Okay, cool.
I'm going to take you to Stacey's class. You're going to have a ball.
Okay, good.
Because it's like a disco for older people.
Oh, very nice.
Not that you're an older person.
No, I'm in. I'll take it. I'm with it. Totally.
I'm fine.
Totally.
Yeah.
So did you hear about, now we're all enjoying like a nice warm weather situation here.
All right.
I know. Not to be the...
You guys, You guys, it was 17 on Saturday.
I know, yeah. Well, so let's enjoy this day, because today is going to be about 60.
Really?
Right? Yes, yeah. So enjoy that as much as you can, because a cold front is coming. Yep. And snow late this week could be the first of several disruptive snowstorms. I know, yeah.
I can't take it anymore.
Yeah, so let's stay indoors or do a lot of soul cycle,
yes.
And that's what we're going to be doing.
Yeah. I have to say that this is the Harry Potter weather of New York City,
yes.
in March.
Hmm.
March, it is 60, then it snows, then it's 60, then it snows.
Right.
And all I know is I always have the wrong coat.
Yeah, you never know what to wear, right?
My coat is always wrong.
Oh,
on the day it was 17, I had a windbreaker.
Yeah.
And today, I wore a Canada Goose.
Yeah, yeah.
So,
thank goodness for those Canada Goose jackets, right? Those are fantastic, but in the right circumstance.
I said to Mark, what did I do before I got a really warm coat? Because I didn't used to, before I got married and became an adult and had children.
Yes.
And it wasn't really until I had children,
right.
that I bought myself a warm coat.
Wow.
Because I was so focused on buying them warm coats, and
that's,
I said,
interesting. Yeah.
This coat is warm.
Yeah, yeah.
And yeah. I bought myself a warm coat, and guess what? It was amazing.
Yeah.
Because I used to just buy coats for how they looked on me.
Okay, so not actually for the practicality of it.
No, it never occurred to me to buy a coat that would be weather resistant.
No, of course, of course. It's all about the style and how it looks.
Right.
No, I know. No, it's incredible to me how little clothing women can wear out in the freezing cold weather.
If their legs are exposed, I go, it's insane. If we look,
the level of strength that it takes to be a woman is phenomenal. I take my hat off to you. We couldn't do it.
It's a lot to kill us.
There's no way we can do it. Yeah, yeah.
It truly does take a lot to kill.
You know what? I saw Logan last night.
Oh,
I went and saw it. Did you cry? I did, yeah. I wanted to come in here today and say I didn't cry because I've shared so many things this week about my love of The Bachelor,
right,
my crush of Daniel Craig, and I cried at Logan. So I'm like a triple threat of...
Yeah, we like it. We like that about you. We like that a lot about
But fantastic
you.
Movie.
Yeah.
I really loved it.
It
yeah,
opened,
very powerful.
It opened huge at the
Huge, $85
million. $85 million.
So good for, again. Hugh Jackman is great in it, and I loved it.
Hugh Jackman and Samuel L. Jackson and all of those guys that open those movies.